Hi, I'm Rich Sains, and this is The Procurement Conversation. In this series, I've been fortunate to speak with inspirational young procurement leaders from different sectors, roles, and regions. By sharing their stories, we want more people to hear about procurement, including the leaders of tomorrow. Welcome to The Procurement Conversation. This week, as part of our Young Leaders series, we're talking to Anne Daunt, who's Category Manager at Vodafone Procurement and a Procurement Manager at Hands-On. Anne, good morning.
Good morning, Rich. Exciting to be here.
How did you get into procurement and why didn't you do something else?
Yeah, that's the million-dollar question, right? First of all, I love this creativity kind of area that what we have in procurement. And actually, I started off at CNA, which is a retailer, and I had the incredible opportunity to be a trainee. And at that time, the role was called product manager. So I was working with the designers, working with lots of different countries, of course, working on the product, but also sourcing in the Far East. So we would fly over to Bangladesh, India, and in China, Indonesia. And it was just an incredible 5 years. And in those 5 years, I understood that sourcing is so much fun. I love that, creating deals, products, services, contracts. And after that, I really went into procurement or the sourcing side. So I started off a little bit more in a creative way, in that product management. And then I realized I also can get creative in this kind of commercial way of working, which I never expected, because procurement is a role that you don't really know that it's out there when you graduate from university.
So what is it you particularly love about procurement?
Yeah, like I said, that creativity. So I would say I'm quite a creative person. And although procurement does entail quite a lot of analytics, and I have to say when I started so many years ago, at that moment in time, knowledge was power. And whatever kind of knowledge you had, for example, in my first years about buying textile, knowing how prices were, or later on when I was working for Heineken, like if you understand how indirect procurement is, you have a little bit more of that power. But I think right now you see that there is much more creativity coming up, like creating new kind of ways of interacting with your sales, interacting with your stakeholders, creating other deals than just looking at pricing or payment terms. It's much more every single deal, every single sourcing project is so different. And I think you really have to see it as you're creating all the time, of course, value, but also something new. And that for me, I'm a person who gets bored very easily. I don't like the typical 9-to-5 or like the repeating or recurrent tasks. For me, procurement brings that. It's almost like a counterpart of, I think, sales, huh? Which is also very interactive and different. But I quite like that internal kind of working with stakeholders and also our suppliers.
So you mentioned there you're not into the 9-to-5, but what does a typical day look like for you?
Of course, we do start at 9 or a little bit earlier. So it's not that we're flexible, at least that we're super flexible working from home or working from anywhere. But you do have, of course, a typical start. But typical my day would, or actually my week, I don't even know in advance how my week would look like. So, of course, you have recurrent projects that are typically RFPs or RFIs or contract renewals that you know in advance. But that's what I really like. I do not know when I start on Monday morning how the week's going to turn out. It could be that suddenly, and for example, specifically with AI coming up or when COVID hit, there were so many different ways of interacting with suppliers at that time that it's not, and not every week is the same. And that's what I like about it. So you could be talking with stakeholders and challenging them about, for example, procurement of their SaaS contracts. And the next day, you're trying to create a product that you can sell to your customers. So it is so different. And that's really what I like. So typically, I would say you have the recurrent projects and then, of course, contract renewals. But then we also have this kind of new ways of bringing in, thinking of new contract, new deals. But yeah, I quite like that differentiation and creativity, as I mentioned.
And anything you don't like so much?
of course, all this admin, or when you do a deal, the last 10%, that's the horrible part, right? Like closing a contract or getting it through signatures or getting it through approvals. I really don't like that at all, getting to the purchase to pay process. Although I do, that's why I think I'm a little bit obsessed now with AI. I like that technology might take over these things. I'm hoping it will help us to automate more of those boring tasks, because I think a lot of procurement professionals don't particularly like that one. But yeah, it is part of the job still, that admin, that contracting, that purchase to pay. But if I could choose, I would immediately outsource that.
I think a lot of people share that, definitely around the contract piece, where you've had, especially when you've had a really good negotiation and everything's been going quite well during the contracting piece, and then you just get to the end. Yeah. And it's either like a big curveball that a senior person throws in, or it's just that going around getting everyone to approve and everyone having questions, and you're thinking, oh, they're going to just completely throw this one back at you. And it's, that can be difficult. So you mentioned AI there, and obviously, I think we're all very hopeful about the impact that AI can have onto procurement, and that will leave procurement needing some, some key core skills. What would you say those key skills are?
First of all, and I think it's quite commonly out there, I think it will be focused more on softer skills. Typically, as I mentioned, procurement, when I started, was very focused on analytical skills, even negotiating skills, knowledge, understanding very well what you need. Of course, that is still needed. But with technology and with the knowledge being out there and so quickly available and so easy available, I think it starts to be more about being empathic, understanding the other side of the table, understanding your stakeholders, and really challenging. It's still a human to human business. Although we all represent targets and companies, it is still working with people in the end. So although technology, and it is, we're going to work together with robots. Yeah, it's not going to happen in the next 10 years. It's going to happen in the next 10 days. We have to embrace it. But we also need to make sure that the human kind of the empathy or that understanding of what really a business need, or the person even that you're working with need, I think that will be the main focus, that kind of softer skills, EQ, understanding how to listen, active listen to people, and then work with that information.
And how do you learn and develop yourself?
I've always been a little bit of a geek in technology. So I remember when the first 3D printing came out, or Alexa came out, I was like on the front, on the first row to get into tech. So I really like that technology to help me in the end to develop, like I mentioned, those softer skills. And because in a sense in procurement, it is not so much rocket science. Every single person could do the job if you're just eager to learn. And I really try to focus on how do I get things quicker out there, quicker to the market, and how can I be more efficient? So again, that technology part is helping me a lot. And it's also challenging me to do better every day. I think I quite like that way of challenging myself in automating and adding technology into a human interaction.
Yeah, I think a few people have said anyone can buy, but very few people can buy well. And it's that thing is that everyone feels like it's something that they're able to do, but actually the way that you do it as a professional is totally different, and it takes a lot more. I was interested there as well, you said about speeding up the process. Do you think that the procurement process is something that's generally too slow and can be sped up?
It depends, of course, on the context and the company and industry and on the deal itself. But generally, yes, I think we can say that we're potentially a slower a department that could slow things down. It's also because we are the end of the chain. So typically, of course, already stakeholders or a deal has gone through a lot of steps before it sometimes ends up in our desk, unless we are really there from the beginning, which I think is a challenge for every single procurement professional to be there from the start. If you can do the full E2E process, then I think it's fine. but we have to be realistic. It's not always there. So yes, I think we can do quicker things. And I think it relates to that closing that contract, the last 10%. We always want to have it very perfectly done and having all the risks covered. Does it really always have to be? Does it really? No, I think we're bringing Agile in and that methodology since a few years. Just go out there, do that MVP, do that kind of, just start with it. And along the way, you can adjust it. And yes, I think that's what we need. More speed, simplicity towards the market.
And what are you most proud of in your career?
I'm actually really proud just on myself, on believing myself. Because when I started so many years ago, there was still a big gender gap. And I remember when I was sitting on an airplane to Bangladesh, and luckily at the time we were flying in business class, I could look around and I could see, oh my God, I'm like the only young lady. When I went then to the buying room in Bangladesh, I was the only lady. So it was really tough because suddenly you need to do the deals. Am I good enough? Am I knowledgeable enough? Will they not just see me as just like this young girl? What is she doing? And I think pushing through and really believing in what you're doing and just fake it sometimes until you make it, I'm proud of that. Yeah, so I'm proud of standing strong and challenging also procurement right now, every single day. Not only as a female, but also as just an experienced procurement person. So I'm proud that I am very authentic and I'm always myself. And that I can challenge as well the way we work every single day.
What would you say your period of greatest growth was?
Every era, and I'm going to quote Taylor Swift, like a hidden Swiftie. I think every era of my life until now has had the ups and downs or things to be proud of. And I'm actually really looking forward to the next era. As I mentioned, I'm a little bit of a geek when it comes to technology. And I think for the first time, I do see that there is so much leverage and so much value that we can bring. So I'm really looking forward for the next, let's say, 6 months to a year. And I think looking at my personal brand, let's say, or my personal impact on procurement, yeah, I think that will be in the next years to come.
And what do you see as the external perception of procurement?
Yeah, it is often seen as slowing down, and because as we mentioned already, it's at the end of the chain or always at the start. And I think that indeed worries me a bit, that we are not quick enough to the market. So I think that potentially sometimes a wrong perception. First of all, I'm being not quicker. I think the next one is that we have these magical Disney powers that we can decrease any increase of a price. I think those are really two really wrong perceptions. And I think we all have the responsibility to, challenge the stakeholders, but also challenge suppliers that we are just not here for getting 30% off. It's just more than that. It's about creating relationship, creating goals, deals together. So I think that is still a perception. I remember like when I started in procurement, my friends would always say, well, we are going to the restaurant. Oh, and you do the negotiation? Like, well, when we have to talk about a price. And I'm like, guys, negotiation is like 5% of what I do on a daily basis. So I think there is still a lot that we need to get out there. Yeah.
Yeah, I see that. And you do get, there's some stakeholders that just think that procurement is an administration function, almost like purchasing or something that it would have been 30 or 40 years ago. And then there are others that think that you are literally magicians and you just go in there and there's some Jedi mind trick on the supplier and suddenly they've given 50% off. And that any budgetary challenge they've got, I've got £100,000 to do this thing and the supplier's saying it's going to cost like £500,000. You'll be able to sort this, won't you? And yeah. I've seen that quite a lot.
Disney is a wonderful brand, but we should not operate too big, let's say, in that matter. I don't have a magical trick. So, yeah, it's really funny when I have this conversation.
So The next question was looking ahead, where do you see procurement going? I feel like you're quite bought into the whole AI piece. I guess if we drill down that a bit further, do you really see it happening in the next sort of 3 to 6 months? Or do you think, obviously, it depends a little bit on an organization's maturity from a digital point of view, but is this something you think will make a big impact in the next 3 to 6 months, or do you think it's maybe a bit longer term?
It's like you mentioned, it really depends on the company. Typically, what is 2023 was the aha moment. And I think this year is typically where in any congress that you go, any webinar, whatever, if you don't drop the AI word, then I think you're behind. But I think what definitely this year will bring is to understand, okay, how does it now impact exactly my business or my process or my department? And I think 2025 will be an implementation. So although I do think that bigger companies have a wider span of people and of possibilities and even budget, I think actually SMEs have an incredible advantage to go quicker because they don't have all these lengthy security and confidential and all of that. So for me, I would put definitely my money on procurement organizations within smaller SMEs, because they will be winning this year.
And where do you see your career going?
I always said already from the first day that I started working, I have to have one thing, and that is fun. If I cannot have fun in what I'm doing, I'm leaving or I'm stopping. Of course, it's not every single day. I'm not going to pretend that every single day is wonderful and sunshiny and whatever it is. But I always had like this tagline, effort in a job brings perfection into work. I think it's Aristotle or Plato who said that one. It is really true. So for me, it is having fun in what I do. And I love procurement. I did 2 years of marketing and I came back because I do like that creativity and interaction a lot. So for me, it is building my personal brand as a procurement professional. Because I think it is, even when in Vodafone, it's important, but also pushing Vodafone even further and being one of the forefront runners in technology and AI, but also challenging myself on still having to find that funness in what I do.
What advice would you give to someone who's considering a career in procurement?
Like I mentioned, I, of course, love the job, but that doesn't mean that anyone else loves it. But I think if you're curious in understanding how deals are done in a company, how money flows, how products are created or services are created, I think if someone is curious in that, then I would say either you have a taste on sales and do also taste a little bit in procurement. And if a person is comfortable in, of course, interacting with other people, because not every, I've seen in the generations that, because I also teach and I also see them on the work floor. If you're not comfortable in having difficult conversations with other people, then don't go into procurement. But if you like that one and you're curious to understand how you can actually be part of creating value, of creating revenue, I think that is the right spot then for a person who wants to go into a procurement role.
And how do you think we could get more young people into procurement?
I think first of all, I think the universities, they need to promote the role more. I see that as well in both in Luxembourg and in Belgium, because I'm originally from Belgium, but working in Luxembourg, of course. I see it coming in more and more, at least in supply chain kind of masters or bachelors. So I think that helps. But next to that one is social media is so big. I adore TikTok and LinkedIn. And I think sometimes people think that TikTok is still a dancing kind of platform. It isn't. So you could really leverage all those social media platforms to promote that kind of procurement role. Sales is so much out there, but actually, if you like sales, you will like procurement as well. So I think it's also driving like what you're doing, but other ones as well, driving and pushing the agenda of procurement towards younger people.
I think that's a great point. And that's one of the reasons why we're doing this series, is just to get that word out there. And yeah, we'll maybe some TikTok little bites and things. And lots on LinkedIn, obviously. But we can all do a bit more to spread the word, can't we, I think?
Yes, absolutely. A bit more snackable and less boring content than the usual Big Four content that we all know.
That's the thing. I suppose you have to make it 10 seconds and little bite-sized pieces. But Anne, thanks for joining today. Really appreciate the conversation. And good to talk.
Yeah, thank you so much, Rich. And I'm so looking forward to all of the rest of the conversations. And I would say let's push this procurement agenda to the new generation, but also let's ensure that the current generation is still competitive and understanding that technology is now part of what we can improve and enhance our role.
Thank you. Thanks for listening. Do like and share and subscribe to hear the next procurement conversation.